Hi, today I will say a few words about my plan of research. The investigation I finished in 1919, but I also did some symbol sky research last year, and I want to say some words about my conclusions. Well, first of all, about the practical application of water reflection method or water scrying. Well, the first that came to my mind was analysis of the patient's subconsciousness in psychoanalysis or psychotherapy. Actually, I'm already trying this with myself. I explore my subconscious motives, urges, through water, as quite often water gives me some of my thoughts, some hidden thoughts or evident thoughts. It's rather interesting. I think it can be applied in real life, but we actually don't know exactly to what extent this type of telekinesis is safe for people, and we don't know how many people really can do it, so it has some difficulties. Investigating crimes, receiving identikits of criminals. Well, this one is the hardest thing to do, actually. Because, yes, I know that some people in RTC sphere, they receive faces of dead people, and if their quality of water pics is high, then actually faces can be recognized. But it happens very rarely. Actually, good quality water pics that don't look like pareidolia, such quality is rare, and theoretically, yes, it can be applied in such spheres, but it's rather troublesome because of low quality of images, and also because we don't exactly know what information we got from the afterworld or from subconscious telepathic network, where that information is coming from, and how reliable is the source. So it's rather a difficult question whether to apply it so or not. Medicine body scan. Well, actually, it's mostly for the future, because now these scrying methods are underexplored. Actually, the quality of images can be better, and it's not fully dependent on psi skills. It is mostly about technique, but not always. So actually, it could be developed in future, but maybe in distant future. Also, as we can do symbol scrying, then it is possible to maybe to determine which part of body is sick by scrying. But surely such methods have to be checked by other, more certain scientific methods. It actually needs much research to explore whether these methods can be applied in medicine or not. This needs more resources and more money and more interested people to research this. But theoretically, yes, the possibility to determine some illness by water scrying, it exists, but it's rather dubious right now. A type of visual art. Well, this one is the simplest possibility, and it surely it's how it is supposed to be developed right now, because lots of people can do this. Especially symbol scrying technique is a quite easy, and is easier to be applied than faces scrying technique. So developing scrying as a type of art is the best way, I think, as we maybe can't make it official science right now, but we can make it a type of art, and a thing that can make the world brighter and can show us some new meaning. Receiving some tips from scientific fields from the afterworld, contacting scientists that are already in the afterworld, and can serve as written documents with high quality water pics. All this is again a difficult application, as we don't exactly know who we are talking to when we are contacting the afterworld. Quite often the sources are impossible to be checked, who is talking to us, or is it just a telepathic network uploaded data. So, well, maybe there is a possibility to receive some, even some scientific information from the afterworld. Maybe not. Actually, symbol scrying has more opportunities for this, because it's material and it can be developed, and the result can be recorded quite clearly. So maybe this way we can receive some definite scientific data from the afterworld. But we can't be sure if this is right, and there is another problem that we often can't distinguish the subconsciousness from the spirit's information. So we can receive our own subconscious thoughts and think that it's from the afterworld, or on the contrary. So it's rather vague. Well, this is actually the most interesting application of this method. Using it at some devices, if we suggest that lots of people have such skills, for instance, some kinds of digital locks or other recognition appliances. Well, actually, it can be done, but as I stated in later experiments, projecting numbers or letters into what is not so simple. Maybe only two or three letters can be projected, and not always. So it doesn't work smoothly. That's why such devices maybe won't work the right way. It can work, but not always. Surely there are lots of difficulties, but it can be settled somehow if people explore this. As to other recognition appliances, well, I actually thought about creating some kind of a computer, some kind of a computer that can transmit information from the afterworld, for instance, from scrying just to the screen, so it can be some kind of a afterworld internet. Actually maybe possible, but maybe not, because there are lots of difficulties in transmitting information even by scrying. About possible future experiments. The first one, checking the way how thoughts can influence search engines, newsfeed, and checking random word generators, how they are influenced by thoughts. Well, about thoughts influencing search engines and newsfeed, I actually don't exactly know how to explain it. Maybe it's global synchronicity, maybe I don't exactly know how these engines work. Maybe it is explained by some randomness, but I'm not sure. From this I actually came to a thought to check random word generators, and recently I'm actually doing some new experiments, and indeed random word generators can answer our thoughts. So actually I made no more than 10 tries with this question, and indeed you can ask a question to a random word generator, and for instance you choose a set of 5 words, and these 5 words can be meaningful and answer your question. It is possible, even from the first try or second try. This is very strange, and actually, I don't exactly know how it can be explained. Maybe thoughts influencing such engines, but we should know how these engines and these generators work. Are they real generators? Are they influenced by some computer noise or some other random data, or they are a bit artificial? It matters. So this is another question to study. Well, the second one, studying car numbers and several cars forming phrases. Well, this is actually a proof to telepathic network, as drivers somehow synchronize to each other to form some meaningful phrases. And it happens while they don't know about it. So there must be some even telepathic center from which it is directed. But this center is maybe the whole entity, it is not located anywhere. It's an interesting question. Yes, it can be studied, it just needs some real experiments and observing it every day, officially recorded, but actually I alone can't do this. Meaningful URLs in base 64. Well, this one mostly concerns YouTube URLs and the videos on YouTube or VK images URLs. Well, this actually I don't exactly know how it can be explained. It's again maybe about some random data that can be made into some order. Well, there is no complete randomness in this, but actually this base 64, it depends on some random data, on some and also on the content of images or videos that are uploaded. So if there is some global synchronicity that exists everywhere, maybe it can be spotted in such things. If not everything is predicted, but some things are predicted. Backward meanings. Well, the first, deciphering important historical texts would require much time, but it will help to reveal subconscious code. Well, actually, deciphering even less historical text, well, it can reveal subconscious code. Just in any text, such code can be revealed, but we don't exactly know where it can lead us to. Maybe some telepathic structures are rather typical and maybe even repeated in many texts. The situations are rather archetypal, so they repeat. And we don't exactly know to what circumstances this can lead us, as gonna be changing in the world while we are deciphering such texts. I can't say it is dangerous, but I just don't know how it can influence our world. Well, another people's backward names. You have to study some people who agree to list some details of their lives known to check if their lives coincide with backward karmic programs. I guess it would have to be more than 1,000 people. Well, this is rather interesting, actually rather amusing. I studied about 40 people already. I deciphered 40 people's backward names and they all coincided with their lives. I mostly studied famous people. I also studied about 200 people more, but I can't write all of them, as some details are personal, some are rather unacceptable to society. Well, just, you know, backward names can be rather awkward in meaning. So, it has to be people who agree to let their life known a bit. Well, yes, this is very interesting. Why exactly their backward names coincide to their fates and to their characters? It can be explained partly that they subconsciously decipher. If their backward meanings are written in their own language, then they can subconsciously decipher and decide to act on this program. But if the backward names are in different languages, then they can't possibly know what it is there in their names. Another explanation can be is that, well, there are some archetypal structures in language anyway, some typical situations, and if we decipher backward texts, there are some rather typical words with typical plots that can occur in everyone's life, and that is why it coincides, because such plots actually occur in everyone's life, not just in life of particular person. But maybe actually there is a paranormal explanation that we have karmic plans that are a bit predestined. Well, maybe for knowing for sure, we have to study more names. Maybe, yes, thousands of names to determine if this pattern persists in people's lives and how it influences them. Well, another thing, cities' backward names. Study the connection between the city's fate and its backward name and some other backward occurrences. Well, truly, yes, cities are less predestined as cities are made of many people, and backward names only determine some typical characters that are actually too typical and can occur in everyone's life. But again, for knowing for sure, we need to study more of this data. Next one, visual, audio, and other signs. Signs from the sky, randomly arranged objects, people or animals, peculiar sounds or sounds. It can be studied for three reasons. To check how it responds to your thoughts, the same idea to spend a day with a camera on your head. To check if some signs are universal for everyone. To find meaningful coincidences that can't possibly be explained by coincidence. These are mostly signs of a consciously programmed world. For this, I actually have to say that it's the whole approach. It's this point describes the whole approach, how we should see it as a RPG world, as if some program game that we have to study, and we have to study it in a peculiar way, as we have to notice lots of details, and we have to record every detail so that to see if details are accidental or not, and we also have to maybe mix several details in one research to see how it correlates. And yes, an idea is to spend a day with a camera on your head and to record every thought and maybe even every moment to see what exactly coincides. It's hard to describe actually this kind of an attitude to the world, but it can be checked. But I really don't know exactly how to describe it, but it is have to be thought out more. With this approach, we can see that some arranged objects are not accidental. For instance, if you meet some people or objects in your daily life, it can be not accidental, but somehow directed by telepathy, and we should determine how telepathy reveals itself in an ordinary world. Because actually, for instance, if we can change water splashes by telepathy, by telekinesis, but then we can also change anything else in this world. But how exactly this happens and in what way it manifests in everyday life, this we have to determine. Study of correlations of all data connected to a person and one's incarnations. Well, this one is again as a grand checker. It's like backward names. It needs much study. and people who agree to participate. Actually, yes, I said that some personal details, documents, information, it can be related to incarnations, but how exactly it is related and how many people reveal it, we don't know. We don't know if it happens in everyday's life or only in some people. We actually, most people don't know their incarnations, if they are famous incarnations. Or if they are less famous incarnations, they don't know them either. Rare people recall their past lives, so it has to be studied mostly among those who can recall their past lives. And yes, it can be studied, but we don't exactly know the results which can appear out of it. The aim is to determine how a person, how a person's life is organized, how the outer world corresponds to the inner world, how their incarnations correspond to their life, to their life's events, to some information and data gathered around them, how it all coincides. Yes, maybe in some people with more exaggerated features, well, maybe it really can reveal, like in my own life and maybe in many other lives. You just have to spot this pattern. The studying of telepathic nature of EVPs and the mechanism of forming images on water, another new means of ITC. Well, actually, my research is not only about ITC, it's only a small part of this. But yes, for instance, EVPs, as my opinion, and somehow based on atheistic research, that EVPs work by telepathy, not by, it's actually seeking patterns in random noise, but it works by telepathy because there is some evidence that the afterworld exists. And as to images on water and letters and numbers on water, I think it's telekinesis and telepathy, not just a random generator water splashes. I don't think so. And if it's telekinesis, it has to be studied what exactly occurs when water splashes form words, phrases, sentences, some faces and some plots, because there are not only faces, it can be any picture, any image, not only animals, plants, houses, it can be just some topics or some themes that can be transmitted through water, just like any other drawing. Just it is not drawn by pen, it's drawn by the thought. So it has to be studied what exactly happens in the water scrying. The next one, studying other ways of telepathic programming, how it can be applied in everyday's life, how we can possibly arrange people and objects ourselves by thought, recording the process and results. Well, this is, sounds a bit dubious, but we always interact with other people and we don't know how we influence them telepathically. So actually it happens every day and we indeed influence each other telepathically, just we don't know this. It can be consciously studied, maybe we have to do it with caution and some precautions because it's about people, but the thing is it actually happens every day in our life and we only have to notice some patterns, how it all is going on, while we don't notice it. So these ideas have a way to go, it has to be developed, and I don't exactly know how to develop it, especially that I don't have some scientific degree. Well, I'm only an English teacher by profession, and I don't have money for research, and I can't open my own research institute. I'm just telling you my ideas and my plans, that maybe it can be applied somehow, maybe not. Well, I'm trying to explain my point of view so that you could decide whether it is appropriate to research such things or not. Well, then go on more general ideas. Creating a perfect water splash simulator, then setting it in digits and letters recognition software. Another way is big water vessels for receiving phrases and sentences, with automated water shaking and symbols recognition program. Well, about water splash simulator, it's actually different from water scrying, because a simulator, well, it would work like, maybe like a random word generator. But water scrying actually works by telekinesis, so it will be a program that works differently, but maybe such kind of a program can get you results, maybe even better results than scrying. I don't know, because it would work differently. It's just an idea. And just big vessels with automatic water shaking and symbol recognition. It's just for making scrying easier, because scrying is actually a hard profession, if it would be a profession. My hands are often tired or overstrained from too much shaking, and my eyes are tired when I sort out hundreds of images. So surely a symbol recognition program would be preferable. It would make the process easier. And some shaking device would be good. So in this case, we would sort out more quantity of data. As now, I, for instance, sort out 1 minute of video each time I scry. But with some program, we could sort out even hours of videos and ask questions and receive immediate answers. So it needs to be developed, such devices. And the last but not the least, creating a computer simulation of the world based on my data. Well, this I actually also can't do alone. This has to be done by some computer scientists, maybe by physicists. I don't know exactly what may come from it, but we may get a better world understanding. And if indeed such simulation can prove some laws to be working, it may help prove my theory. This may be a lot of work. And another thing I concerning my last experience, extracting information from subconscious telepathic network by symbol scrying. Actually, I already did some of it. It was not very successful. I managed to project some words and phrases, managed to project subconscious thoughts, to solve some math operations. But when I tried to extract definite information, well, it was not successful. I couldn't guess some acquaintances' data, some their phone numbers, for instance. Another thing is, as I talked about, maybe it is possible to transmit some scientific ideas through water. But it actually it's a lot of work, because it needs to we need to sort out much data for this, and I can't do it manually, can't do it alone. Actually, it needs a lot of work, so I'm trying to find some people who could help me. First I'm trying to find them in my own country. Well, I think that the research is possible, and it's maybe interesting, maybe it can lead us to some unusual conclusions about our reality. Well, that is all I actually wanted to say. I have to remind you that my conception is that we live in some kind of an RPG, and it's I call it an RPG theory of a subconscious telepathic network. But this is I call it a theory because I've got many observations and experiments that support my hypothesis. But actually, it's not officially a theory, because It is not officially proved, and no official research was done. But maybe in future something can be done about it, maybe not. I also face some stigmatization because people think I may be insane because of my previous mental illness that I'm diagnosed even now with. But I've been exploring paranormal things for 3 years already, and I find it's fascinating, and it somehow benefits my life, as I find it more interesting to live in such a way, exploring mysteries. And the whole idea of cosmopsychism, that is another conception my research is based on. Cosmopsychism is also fascinating, and I just like the idea, and I gather some facts that can prove it. So thanks for watching, and just try to understand me that I wish no harm to the world. I just want to prove for sure whether my maybe delusional ideas, whether they are valid or not. And I want to prove that this world is only one of dimensions, that there is some kind of an afterlife, and we can get incarnated again. It's actually quite positive, at least for me. And another thing, that we actually could do something with the issue of death or this way, well, because we right now we don't know what to do with the fact that all people are dying, but this new world conception, it actually can benefit the world in many ways. We just don't know exactly how exactly it can be done, what exactly are the positive things of this conception. But maybe in future it can lead to some scientific progress. Well, if the theory is wrong, then it won't lead to scientific progress. But if the theory is right, or even partially right, then it can bring some positive changes to society and to the world and to science and to art in general. Thanks for watching.